Are you done?
Sebastian, say what you gotta say.
Thank
yo.
You. That whole situation, you didn't say not a damn thing. It revolves around choice. If a woman wanna
see that's what y'all talking about though. Like
mine, I'm walking away. That's it. Nothing else to talk about. If you're just talking about what I'ma do, I don't know what they gonna do, but I'm out.
Hold up, pause.
First of all, women take care of children that aren't theirs all the fucking time and don't make a big ass deal about it. Pause!
Damn, that's a way to start off. And her voice is loud. Oh. Care about people's names like that. I'm sorry. It's a nice beat though. It's just too long. Come on, man. Let's get to the point. Let's go.
I'm the only one here that's gonna be missing.
Speaking of missing.
Come on,
guys. When people try to compete for love, I got you. It's not competing when you woke up with it.
Wow. Amen to the Heavenly Father.
Amen.
So now that we're here, the energy's...
I don't even know what they're talking about. But the ball-headed one, I don't like her. I'm just waiting for her to explode and blow up again. Let's see what they're talking about. I already know what they're talking about. They're talking about the DNA test. Okay? So, here we go.
Lately, I've been very paranoid about unknowingly taking care of another man's child and then finding out years later, .. Man's not Santa.
I respect it.
That's how he ended the question.
Kofi from Woolwich, UK.
Thank God. Yo, we're praying for you, Kofi. Thank God. Thank you, Ghana. We'll pray for you, Kofi.
Can y'all spot the simp? Which one y'all think is the simp? It's a simp. It's always a simp is in the show, okay? It's a simp and it's a one of them women who stands out from all the other women to watch.
How many kids are holding? That's
a lot.
There's babies behind you.
Exactly. Hey, the chick with the afro on her head, she ugly. To me, okay?
You to reframe the way you think about black men? That's not how
I love my black man.
So you love black men?
I don't think you love black men, because you look at the clown suit you got on. I don't know, man. That's just not my take.
About the question.
So you feel like you should definitely be, I think that testing needs to be mandatory. It's like,
wow!
It should be mandatory.
You won't be scared about who's pregnant.
Slinging your dick around, bitch, that look, automatically she thinks that it's somebody else's fault.
18 years, and on her 18th birthday found out it wasn't his. Now I ain't saying she a gold nigga.
You get me?
Tori is stupid. I don't think that, you know, it's something that if you feel like you need a DNA test, go do that on your own time. Because you feel that way. I don't think every person, there's millions of people in the United States. Like, it doesn't make sense that
that's a lot of
people
makeup
could be using that time
too.
To do other things. Like, you could be...
Listen to us. Some women never think that men, they never come to the understanding that maybe it's you. You get me? Like, women argue two ways. They either argue for them personally or they argue for everybody else. When it benefits them, they'll argue for everybody. If it benefits them, they'll argue for self. You get me? Like, if you tell a woman, Like, women are liars. She'll jump in and she'll say something like, I'm not a liar. I've never lied to anyone ever. But that's her way of bringing, helping every other woman out there. Like, bitch, you're not everybody, okay? Y'all are a collective group of people. When you have a lot of women out there who act like freaks and sluts and sleeps with everybody, then lies about who the baby dad is, y'all are a part of that group. You get me? That y'all are with them people. Y'all, yes, you can't argue just for yourself. Y'all are everybody. It's just like when y'all say all men are dogs, and we jump in and say something like, have you slept with everybody? Do you get what I'm saying? It's the same way.
At the end of the day, but if you had known that, and you had that, you didn't give that person that decision.
I feel like if you're in a marriage, you're happy, you're having babies, and it takes a lot to get to that place where, you know, you're having babies with someone, if you're responsible. For the question to be asked, can you take a DNA test? I mean, are you kidding me? Like, what is this? Like, what did we...
Once again, she's thinking of it from her perspective. Okay, maybe you are the one woman out there who won't cheat on her husband and get pregnant by somebody else, but you are not everybody.
I think that y'all... want to jump this in to like be a mandated Black Panther or something because like that. Like of a conversation you are not strong enough to have with your girl.
Is, which one. We already know she ain't got
two. You requesting DNA, first of all, this is a very gendered question, right? There's no way for a woman, well, let me not speak for every woman. Mm-hmm. For me specifically, there's no way if my man came up to me, I wouldn't feel some type of offense. But fine, if you have the right to know whether it's your child or not, because I know this is my child, right?
18 years, and on her 18th birthday, found out it wasn't his. Now I ain't saying she a gold digger.
Right? But to say that it's mandated is where I have a problem. Who is picking up those costs? The U.S. government? The U.S. government should be paying for these mandatory tests for you to know.
Mom's child, daddy's maybe. Oh, mom's baby, daddy's maybe.
Of 7-month-old Namir, Jamal, you are not.
Think about that.
First of all,
she's getting angry. She's angry.
So many ailments that are like people are dying from.
I get not that. Exactly just ailments, like just like feminine
just feminine products. So for you to make that mandatory, that would have to be a government issue.
You know that.
If you want a mandatory test,
which I do,
you pay for it yourself.
I can't find a simp yet. I thought it was a light-skinned dude because he was sitting out relaxed and shit. So I ain't like that.
I personally pay taxes, and I care about where my money goes. I'm not here to pay.
Look at how she dressed. She dressed like a thot, but you want us to respect you. Yeah, no, we can't respect people who doesn't act respectable. You have to be respectable for us to respect you. You get me? Y'all, look, y'all always... Y'all are arguing for something to be done with other people, but y'all are not fixing yourselves. Y'all need to fix yourself. You get me? Look within. You get me? Y'all keep blame talking about the government. We wouldn't need none of these people if women would start acting like women and not sleeping with every fucking body. Now we have to question who is the baby daddy. Nobody remember Mara Povich.
In the case of 3-year-old Nakia, Raekwon.
Push the goddamn button!
You are not
Nobody remember Mara Povich? We don't think of that right there? Okay, let's keep going.
Your relationship and whether that be your child. If you personally want to check for your child, that's you. But to say that it's mandatory across the country, that's crazy. And it's inconsiderate. And it's not.
So you're saying that you will pay for it, right?
Yeah, I'll pay for it.
So if it costs
$10,000, you're gonna pay for a DNA test.
Yes.
18 years, and on her 18th birthday, found out it wasn't his. Now I ain't saying she a gold nigga.
$5,000.
Yes. Whatever it takes to not put me through something that I don't need to go through.
Would you be okay with your wife having you do a lie detective test?
Yes.
You are not.
Yes, because I'm not doing nothing wrong, so I have nothing wrong or anything to fear. Exactly. Why are we even talking about this?
No, because you know what's crazy? In the hospital, women do ask for a DNA test. Men do. People do ask on the line. They'll pull a nurse aside.
He's not a simp.
The question is about it being mandated. So understand.
I think for sure that the person that
the guy in the fucking dude with the beard is just sitting out, just like, I'm just trying to stay neutral. Bitch, argue.
Like this isn't his child. You should be able to say, oh, had this DNA test.
The chick in the like China outfit, the bright skinned chick, she look cool at home. While all the other women look like they ready to fight. Bald headed girl going at it again.
The effects of what that's gonna be
versus a court order
are completely different things. So when y'all wildin' talking about for your
yeah, no woman brings up that these women are nasty.
Whole country, when there are so many other issues,
no woman ever thinks that women out there are making other women look bad.
In the case of 3-year-old Nakia Raekwon, you are not my slut.
She over there doing stuff, I don't know if this is mine.
That's a personal problem, not a country one. It is a personal problem. You don't know if that's your child.
Now she arguing for one. You get me? She's talking about it's your business now. And other times it's all of our business. We need to come together.
Personal.
I think it should only be mandated if you're not in marriage. Yeah, if you're in marriage,
absolutely not.
Women in this situation about the topic in which we're talking about pregnancies and DNA tests, in most cases than not, is going to be you have doubts about who the woman cheating, exactly. And that's why the baby may not be yours. The direct topic question was from a man asking he doesn't want to raise another man's child.
I ain't saying she a gold digger, but she ain't messing with a broke nigga. 18 years, and on the 18th birthday, he found out it wasn't his.
Outside the relationship, he gonna bring the evidence of the cheating. He gonna bring the child. And that's like the part where that's where it hurts the most. Like that's the time where it should be mandatory. If I'm in a marriage, that's when it happens. You're cheating, that's why you would want it. First of all, when it's in that situation, more times than not, when it's like a relationship, is usually the woman who's committed infidelity. Because the guy is assuming if you're in a relationship, if you're married and you're in a relationship, the man is assuming, and most times when you're on Murray, you're watching these cases, you hear about these stories. You're assuming.
In the case of 1-year-old Malay, Amaziah, you are not the father. In the case of 1-year-old Malay, Juan, you are not the
father. You're assuming that.
I almost died because Shabazz said, women are usually the one that's unfaithful. He sounds like he's guilty or something, because a lot of time in a lot of culture, the man is normally the one that's out there cheating. And even guys,
I don't know about all that, man. You get me? Being out there cheating and making babies are two different things. You get me? If you get pregnant, then look, if you cheat on somebody, I get it. But if a baby doesn't come out of it, then it's not even in this conversation. Who's getting pregnant by somebody else's baby? That's the question.
The person to have a question is about if they're the father of that child. They go through the rest of this child's life taking care of it. And if that was me, after 18 years, I'm not going to turn my back on the child. But if I had known from day one, I'm out.
Hold up. First of all, women take care of children that aren't theirs all the
time. She just needs something to grab on. Just like, hey, What about this? What about that? What about that's how she sounds.
You know
what?
You know
that's not me. Pause. What I'm making a declaration between is the fact that this is a personal problem that you have.
Now it's one person. All of a sudden, it's one person, but everybody screams, believe all women. All women. Why we can't just believe that one woman that's telling the truth?
If you're just talking about what I'm going to do, I don't know what they're going to do, but I know I'm out.
I don't think there's any issue with a man taking care of another
I hate
child.
When people don't women use do logic, you get me? Whether I want people to use logic, you get me? But you always looking at personal feelings, so you argue from that perspective. Oh, it's not me, it's not me. Oh, we should all be together. It's not me, we should, whatever works. You get me? So like a survival mode thing. It's not even, you get me?
You could have been doing so many other things with your life. You could have been figuring your life out. I don't know, feeding pigeons. I don't know, doing anything. But you raising a kid that is not yours. I mean, if you had the option to know that was your kid and you wanted to raise that kid, that's perfectly fine. A lot of people do that. But when you don't know, you're doing it out of the obligation or the mindset that this is my child. I'm gonna raise him or her. I'm gonna raise him up. I love them. This is my DNA. This is my blood. And then come to find out, that's not your kid.
You are not. There's a clear disrespect going on, right? If double I have and double standard.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Yes, I understand. It's fucked up if somebody has a child for you and it's not for you and expecting you to raise it. I get that. But what I'm saying is that women, first of all, have to do that all the time. But we have, but first of all, women are in these, women are in.
Now she's arguing for everybody.
Can I finish my damn sentence?
Go ahead.
Women are in the circumstance where they need to take care of a child that isn't theirs all the time. And I understand that, again, that it ends up being a choice, right? Because you're aware.
It is
aware.
A choice.
So that's what I said, Shabazz. So what's up?
You're not making it.
I am making a point. If you let me finish, I'm going to finish it. So stop interrupting me. Because you keep interrupting me.
Finish it. You're not giving the person a choice. Me and A-Crime talking about a choice.
I just
Jarrell,
said
everybody
that.
Sitting there looking at you the same way.
No,
we're trying to mess up.
Choice, but we don't make a choice that we end up doing a personal problem for the government to handle.
We're talking about a mandatory decision.
If you gotta do a mandatory thing, if you gotta make a mandatory decision, someone else has to pay for it. Right. What I'm saying is that women have to face this all the time. By choice or not, it doesn't matter. The government doesn't need to take up for you because you didn't know about something.
That whole situation, you didn't say that damn thing. It revolves around choice. If a woman want to stick around for the kids,
because of choice, the government should be.
Hey, we gotta stop it right there, man. God damn, man. That was good. I like that. Anyway, bye.